convicted. After this fight, neither of them will need us anymore. No shit. Floyd doesn't need us right now. He's opening strip clubs. Floyd will go back to retirement, presumably for good this time, with another nine-figure paycheck. Bitter much, Oscar? And Connor will go back to the USC. Again, bitter much, Oscar? And by the way, Connor won't go back to the UFC. Once he makes $100 million, he's done too. It's a win-win for them. Right. It's a lose-lose for us. But why would it be a lose-lose for us? We'll be $100 lighter, and we will have squandered another opportunity to bring boxing back. Okay,
Hold on.
He is wrong. It's not taking the place of another fight.
It's not.
That's what he's discussing this as. Like, I'll spend my $100 on that fight as I would spend the $100 on his fight. Look, now that you guys are streaming shit online, I'll pay $100 every time just so that I don't have to be tied to that stupid viewing room, my fucking TV, or anything else. I am down with paying the $100, okay? And I'll watch the circus all day long. At this point, only we can shut down the circus. No, I'm going to tell you the truth about boxing fans, Oscar. They're not going to shut it down. In fact, what you've done is thrown more gasoline on this fight. Fuck.
Yeah. Yes, he has. Yes, He's promoting it.
No doubt. Okay, let me finish it out. At this point, we can only shut the circus down by making it clear that we don't want to pay to see a joke of a fight, telling our casual fan friends that they shouldn't either. Sincerely, Oscar. You're wrong. Here's what I would tell my casual... Look, I take BJJ. All of them are going to pull for Connor.
Yep.
And my answer to everybody who's in MMA or Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu, he won't be able to grab him, okay? He just won't. If he actually learns... Do I think that Connor McGregor has the ability of landing one punch per round? Yes. And to be perfectly honest, that will be more punches. Oscar, listen closely. If Connor lands one punch per round, he will do better than Chavez did against Canelo.
Fucking A,
so,
right.
Fuck you, Oscar. Right there in your face. Booyah.
Listen.
All he's got to do is land one punch, and he's fighting at the same level of the same fucking fight you put on. You piece of shit.
And not only that.
I mean, that's the
truth. Mayweather fans are, they love Floyd, all right? There's really nothing
love
Floyd
it.
Can do
they
wrong.
They love it.
Yeah. This fight is a sellout for Floyd
fans.
Oh, my
God. You've got a white Irish guy against as black a guy as you can get. I don't want to get racial, but let me tell you what this means to betting gambling in Vegas. This is just money on money, and all Connor has to do is use his better cardio and land a couple of punches, and nobody's going to be disappointed. Nobody. Every punch he lands will be more climactic than the next.
All they need to see, I told you guys this months ago, they just need to see him do barely enough to make it seem that an MMA fighter can stay in the ring
right.
with a boxer.
And I'm going to say
he's totally not annihilated.
I'll go a
it
step
It is a win for the UFC.
I'll say it's a step further. Okay. Boxing always needs a white guy to get his ass kicked. That's reality.
You know what? That's a plus, but that's a
right?
plus for
okay.
this fight.
Would you not agree that the current climate of our country is a little pro right wing and white?
What the media is showing us? Yes.
Yes. Right?
Yes. Yes.
Okay, we're all a bunch of racist white people who hate anybody else of color. Like they, people don't need much to get behind on this topic, right?
Yeah. If you watch the videos, they're a little bit more outspoken than they have been in the.
I'm telling you,
past.
They make this fight. You're looking at 3 to 5 million pay-per-view buys. Like it's
of
a
course.
Crazy. It's a crazy number.
Lee, do
it's
you
a
know,
number that you can't even conceptually put into
this,
your mind.
This is why he's so wrong by saying it hurts
he
the sport.
He's
it
so full
doesn't.
Of shit. Because here's the thing, all on, the undercard is going to be boxing.
Who cares about the undercard? This is about
oh, I'd say it's a great showcase.
Finally showing the MMA, you don't fucking stand toe-to-toe with a professional boxer. Period.
Well,
all of their fucking
that's what I,
No.
I'd see it as a great opportunity for
all of their arguments comes to a close on that night. Don't you get it? Every time Floyd fucking faints and slaps him around and moves around him and has him looking stupid, smiling, not being able to hit him, we are going to look at our MMA fan and go, did you really expect anything different? Did you really? Right. We've been telling you for a decade that you people cannot go toe-to-toe with us.
And then in the sixth round, when Connor puts him into the corner, wait, listen, tell me this isn't the outcome of the fight, and predetermined, because that's the way Floyd is. In the sixth round, when Connor takes him into the corner frustrated and puts a knee right into the center of his chest to get disqualified.
You know who else said that? Mike Tyson agrees with you. Mike Tyson thinks he's going to cheat to get out of the fight.
Round number six, and take his payday.
And stand there
with his hand over his head going, fucking guy didn't want to fight me.
I'm sorry. I thought I was in the MMA. Yeah, right. I hear you.
Or he throws an elbow and knocks him.
Yeah.
Whatever.
It comes naturally to me. I'm sorry. I use all my weapons. Yep. I totally hear you.
And MMA's not hurt. Boxing's not hurt. Everybody's jacked up. And here's the worst part. We're ready for the rematch of that fight.
Hey.
If you want to say you thought it was a circus the first time.
Oscar is scared about the 130,000 pay-per-view buys that Triple G can only gather in two pay-per-view sales.
Versus Canelo is 1 to 2 million buys, somewhere in that range.
I think it barely does one.
They might get some crossover.
Triple G is already known. He's already known. The 300,000, those are guys that already have paid to watch Canelo. They paid to watch Canelo versus Cotto. They paid to watch Canelo versus Mayweather. They paid for Canelo versus Chavez. 300,000 compared to 1 million or 2.4. I'm sorry. Those fans are already in those numbers. So
what
you're not
was,
bringing
What
nothing.
Was Pacquiao Mayweather when it was all said and done with pay-per-view and everything?
I think 4.9. Is what they
so you, what you're looking at if they can really make McGregor versus Mayweather, right? It's got to be double that. It's like an 8
I
million
believe
views,
over
10 million views.
I said over 5. I think it would do over 5 million easily.
That's just pay-per-view, but if you're talking UFC running it on their site that week and you're talking
circuit.
About HBO and closed circuit, you've got to talk arguably a 10 million view situation. It's a crossover of epic proportion.
It's one of those I told you so fights, and we don't care how bad it looks.
Right, we don't care. We just want people to be excited about
it's
fighting.
It's just like when he slapped the shit out of Manny. Do you really think I was like, oh, man, this is such a boring fight? No.
Same thing when I saw Chavez, right.
I knew it was going to be a boring fight. Right. And two, I knew Floyd was going to slap the shit out of Manny. So as he's doing it, I'm telling all of my Manny fans, did you really think it was going to be different? That he couldn't stop a jab right hand from Marquez, but he's going to stop it from the best in the world.
Right. Right. And it's no different than Canelo Chavez. No different.
No difference.
No difference. Except I will say this. I actually expect Conor McGregor to land more punches than Chavez did.
That's all he has to do.
And here's why. I will make a strong argument on this. I think McGregor has better cardio.
No doubt.
And he'll be at weight.
He's more dedicated, Lee.
Yeah.
Chavez Jr. is not as dead. Remember, Chavez Jr. tried to back out of training with Nacho Bernstein.
Yeah.
That's when you know that he's not that guy. He is not that guy. He's Kell Brook at a lower level. Oh, sorry, Kell. Sorry, I'm not.
Geez. It happens.
I'm going to say back.
That'll do it for this episode of Fight Net Radio. That's a big, long show for you guys. I hope you enjoyed it with plenty of me saying plenty of shitty things. I'm sure that I will put some kind of mean hater title up.
No, I like the Kell Brook mental. I'd say you go with that. Not with the stamina, okay? But something about Kell Brook mentally.
Kell Brook's being mentally weak.
He's just not that guy. He really isn't.
All the English fans are going to say I'm a hater.
There was a lot of them that were very disappointed, though. They're asking for retirement. If you both of your eyes are breaking, you know what I mean? If you're going to keep saying, oh, my eye socket's broke, got to, you know, backing out of the fight, well, then maybe you should just not be fighting.
You shouldn't be fighting. I still believe that that's why we haven't seen Timothy Bradley. I think that left eye is an issue.
But you know what? Bradley fights, Lee. How many times have we seen Bradley almost
his eye's going to pop out of his head.
And then, and he's almost knocked out and he's coming back. And no, that guy puts it on the line, though. He doesn't do what we seen last night. And I don't know what category he falls into, but all three of them are bad. And they don't warrant an A-side fight. Not anymore.
And everybody jump onto Oscar's page and in the comments on Facebook where he posted this blog, put fuck you, Oscar.
Oh, let me, and real fast, I brought it up already, wanted to go back to it. So Cotto is not retiring. Cotto's fighting Kamagai July? I think it's in July also.
Nothing like just taking a payday to take a payday.
But hold on. And then it's Marquez at the end of the year. And then Miguel Cotto even said he thinks he's signing with Oscar for 2018. So to all your Cotto fans that thought this was the final year, it will not be.
Wow.
Yeah. All the how fast that changes. I mean, the guy's been contemplating retirement for like a year and a half under Rock Nation, signs with Oscar, and they obviously put a plan in front of him that's going to make him a lot of money, and he's ready to sign until 2018.
There you go. That'll do it. Once and for all. Nice big long Memorial Day weekend. Of course, respect to all of our men and women in the service.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
No doubt about it. If there's one thing, boxing is about as American and red, white, and blue as it gets. And personally, the bigger the circus, the better.
We don't quit. I know that, Lee. Our fighters don't go down to one knee, bro. No, sir. Just kidding. I'm just fucking.
That's not bad. So everybody have a very safe, fun, enjoyable vacation weekend. Enjoy the show. We appreciate all of you listening. Please sign up. Go to fightnetradio.com. Sign up. Just do it on iHeartRadio. It'll cover both your Android and iOS applications. For Andrew Labuche, for me, Lee Honish, we again thank all of our men and women in the service for serving and protecting our country and doing what you do, because truthfully, Andrew and I are basically cowards and wouldn't do it.
I know, I regret that.
So. We wouldn't do it. We wouldn't do it.
I regret it. Thank you.
Though. My family's military, and I'll say it.
All of ours. Yeah, a lot of ours are. I don't know what the hell happened to us grandkids, man.
We're pussies.
Whatever.
We're pussies. We're generationally pussies.
That's fucking.
Do you even own a gun, Andrew?
Oh, yeah.
All right. Good job. Yeah. He's in Oakland. Gotta be careful.
I went to sign and then got pulled and then got cold feet. You know, it was something like that. I wish I would never have done it, though. I wish I at least would have put in my four, but hey, it is what it is.
It is what it is. So that all of you that do do it.
Much love.
Much love. Respect. Big time from us.
I will say.
Yeah.
Hey, I never back down here. So while they're over there defending, I'll do my best to try to help them here. How about that one, Lee? Help their families out here. Yes, sir.
Absolutely. Thanks, everybody, for listening to the show. We will see you again next week. Thanks for listening.
Thank you for enduring another episode of FightNet Radio. FightNet Radio is available for download and subscription on iTunes. Or visit FightNet Radio and tell us how offended you are by today's show. Thank you for listening.